Of microeconomics. In this topic today, we'll cover some basic terms of economics. So let's get started. First one is economy. You must have observed so many things are happening around you, like construction, buying, selling, factories, shops, offices, transporters, buses, railways, etc. All these organizations are involved in the three economic activities. That is production, consumption and capital formation. Capital formation means the investment. Okay, these are what these economic activities are doing. They are collectively helping the economy. How they are providing the opportunities to the people to work. So that they will work and they will earn their living. So we can say that economy is a system which provides people means to work and earn their living. Next is, why study economics? What is the need of study economics? See, we have just studied that production, three economic activities, production, consumption and capital formation. What these activities are doing, they are engaged in providing opportunities to the people to work. Okay, so it means these activities we are doing for some specific purpose. Suppose if we go to the restaurant to eat, we are going to the restaurant to eat only. Okay, we are attending the school to get educated. I'm teaching here to earn my living. So we are doing any activity or every activity for some specific purpose. Alright, so economics is also studied to understand the different aspects of economy. Okay, to understand the different aspects of economy. Different aspects means what is economy, how it works, how it runs, like what is demand, selling, scarcity, resources, wants, all these come under economy. So if we understand the economy, then it will be very easy to understand the economics also, the different aspects of economics. All right, next is wants versus needs. Some people say that wants and needs both are same. No, both are different. Needs means the basic necessities of life, that is food, shelter and clothing. All right, and wants means satisfaction. Wants, which gives you the good or the product which gives you pleasure, satisfaction, that is called wants. Okay, suppose example we take it, like suppose if you want to buy a mobile phone. Okay, if you buy a mobile, you can easily work with the mobile phone of rupees 2000 also. Okay, so that is your need. But if you want to buy, you already have a phone and you want to buy a Samsung phone or an iPhone, that means it is your wants, which gives you satisfaction, which adds to your status symbol. Okay, so that is the difference between need and wants. And we know that human wants are unlimited. As soon as you satisfy the first one want, the second one would take place. Okay, next is scarcity. Scarcity means the limitation of supply in relation to demand, or we can say wants exceed the available resources. Here, limitation of supply in relation to demand means, example, it means that demand is greater than supply. Let's take an example. If I wanted to buy a 5 kg apples, all right, but now the vendor means the seller, he is saying I have only 2 kg apples. So what is this? Here, demand is 5 kg and supply is 2 kg. So demand is greater than supply. So when we say that when wants exceed the available resources, here want is 5 kg, all right, and the available resources, that is 2 kg. So it means there is a scarcity. Scarcity means lack, shortage or dearth of resources. Okay, means the shortage, there is a lack of it. Here 2 kg only apples are available in the market, but I want 5 kg apples. Okay, so the main reason for study of economics can be simplified to a single word, that is scarcity. Alright, and scarcity is universal. It doesn't mean you can find scarcity only in the underdeveloped country or developing country. Even in the developed country, you will find a scarcity. Alright, scarcity of resources, because we know that resources are very limited. Alright, next is resources. Resources are of three types. First is natural resources, labor resources, and manufactured resources. Natural resources, we know that it is land, oil, wood, etc. Labor, again, it is divided into two parts, physical resources and knowledge-based resources. Physical resources means the labor who is doing physical work, like the labor you will find in construction sites. Okay, that comes under physical labor, or at the time of harvesting season, like harvesting of wheat for the agriculture, that time also we need the labor, that also comes under physical resources. Second one is knowledge-based resources. Knowledge-based resources means those who are using their brains, like IT personals, they are using, okay, they are doing their work by using their brains, teachers, lawyers, okay, etc. All these come under knowledge-based resources. Next is manufactured resources. Manufactured resources means when we are converting the raw material into a finished product, that comes under manufactured resources, like pen, pencil, fan, refrigerator, AC, bed, etc. All these come under manufactured resources. Now next is economic problem. Economic problem is consist of two words, that is economic and problem. Economic, if I want to define in one word, economic means choice. And problem, you know the meaning of problem. So we can define the economic problem means problem of making a choice is called economic problem. When you are making a choice out of the given resources or different alternatives, that is called economic problem. Let me give you one example. Suppose you have 100 rupees, okay, and here in 100 rupees you want to buy pen, pencil, milk, petrol, chocolate, etc. Okay, now your wants are unlimited. As you can see, your wants are unlimited, because in just 100 rupees you want to buy so many things. So what you need to do, your means are limited in relation to demand. So as your wants are different in urgency, you have to prioritize it. Now you have to think that how should you spend your 100 rupees at the so that you can buy the maximum out of this. All right, it depends only up to you. So this means that you have to make a choice in 100 rupees how much you can buy. All right, that is called economic problem. Next is causes of economic problem. Causes or economic problem, or why does economic problem arise? See, economic problem you will see in every country, whether it is developing, underdeveloped, or developed country. Okay, and the reasons for economic problems is same in all the countries. The first one is scarcity of resources. We know that the resources are very limited, they are scarce. Okay, you cannot satisfy all your wants with the limited resources, and economy cannot produce all what people want. All right, second one is unlimited human wants. We know that human wants are never ending. They are never ending, and you can never be fully satisfied. As soon as one want is satisfied, another want would emerge. So human wants also differ in priorities also, and for every individual, wants are more important and urgent as compared to others. Example, like for me, milk is very important rather than pen and copy. For someone else, pen or pencil is more important than milk. Okay, so it depends on person to person. Next is alternative resources. Alternative uses mean product which have multiple uses, so many uses. Example, milk, petrol, etc., diesel, etc. Like these products have multiple uses. For example, milk. You can use the milk for feeding a baby also, curd, cheese, ghee, etc. Okay, so as a result, an economy has to make a choice between the alternative uses of given resources, that which want which want or problem is necessary. So economic problem means the problem of making a choice. So economy has to make a decision to make to find out which problem is important and urgent to satisfy.